Now he goes on to say, verse 16, let not then your good be evil spoken of. In other words, your Christian liberty today may cause you to be criticized. You need to be careful. For the kingdom of God, he says, is not meat and drink, but righteousness and peace and joy in the Holy Spirit. And how this verse has been abused. This is actually the only reference in this epistle to the kingdom of God. And I personally do not believe it's synonymous to the kingdom of heaven in Matthew, which finds its final fruition in the millennial and messianic kingdom here on earth. Now, I think the kingdom of God embraces actually all that's in God's created universe. And in that, there is the church. And I think that he's having reference to that. And it's broader and larger, and it includes God's reign over all his creation. And I think that Dr. Lang has given us a good, satisfactory definition. He says the heavenly sphere of life in which God's Word and Spirit govern and whose organ on earth is the church. Now, I think that was our Lord's use of the term. Remember, the Lord Jesus says, verily, verily, I say unto you, except a man be born again, he cannot see the kingdom of God. Well, that's that heavenly sphere of life in which God's Word and Spirit governs. And of Dr. Stifler, as we said before, God rules everywhere, but there is a realm where he governs by spiritual forces or laws alone, and that is in the area of the life of the believer. Now, man is totally incapable of seeing or entering this kingdom without the new birth. Now, this kingdom has nothing in the world to do with eating or drinking, fasting, no meat on Friday, no pork or vegetarian diet. These things actually just don't enter into it, my beloved. Righteousness here, I think, would mean the same as it does in Romans. It means to be right with God. It means a life lived well-pleasing to him. And in the Holy Spirit, it goes with righteousness, and it has reference to our standing, not only to our standing, but our walk. It's walking in the Spirit. It's practical rather than theological. It's moral rather than oral. It's a righteousness in the Holy Spirit rather than the righteousness in Christ. And this joy here is something that's absent today in the lives of believers. It's a fruit of the Spirit. There should be joy in our lives. That doesn't mean you got to run around smiling like a Cheshire cat. And then we got a group of song leaders today. I think they don't have anything else to say. And they get up and say, now everybody smile. Well, I learned a long time ago, I don't have to smile just because a song leader wants me to smile, and that doesn't prove whether I'm a Christian or not. I think it's whether you got joy down in your heart.